Hello and welcome. As we know, things happen on a day-to-day basis in our life that can affect our emotional state. Sometimes these emotions can affect badly on our health as well. So it's important that we overcome this situation. In this video, I will be talking about 8 steps for improving poor emotional health. So let's start. In the previous video, we have seen how poor mental or emotional health affects our overall health. When we are stressed or anxious, our body tends to react as if we are under attack, and our body produces hormones that are responsible for a fight or flight response. Too much of this physical reaction can affect your heart as well as emotions, which will ultimately result in feeling moody or depressed. So, relaxing your mind and body will make your body stop producing these hormones that affect your health. Let us see how to improve emotional or mental health. The first step to improve emotional health is to know your emotions and understanding the source of this emotional state. Resolving the cause of the sadness, stress, or anxiety will help in managing the emotional health. The next step is to express your feelings properly. Keeping the thoughts or issues that make you sad, stressed, or anxious to yourself will make you feel worse. So, letting it out in appropriate way will help a lot to improve emotional health. You can share the issues that are bothering you to your family or friends. Sometimes they may not be adequate to guide you. In that case, it's better to consult with a family doctor or a counselor or a religious advisor who can provide better advice and support for improving your emotional health. Another way to cope with your problems or stress is by building resilience. Resilience is the ability to recover quickly from difficulties or crisis. A part of resilience is based on how you think. You can start simply by changing how you think and how you act. As I said earlier, how we think and act affect our overall well-being. So, having a positive outlook will always help in overcoming any crisis and help building resilience. The next thing that you can do is to relax your mind and body. Relaxing your mind and body can help to relieve stress, anxiety, depression, as well as sleep issues. You can follow relaxation techniques such as meditation, breathing exercises, listening to relaxing music, guided imagery, massages, and doing yoga to reduce your stress and relax your mind as well as your body. Some researches shows that the spiritual wellness and physical well-being are linked together. Tending to your spiritual wellness can comfort and strengthen you to handle the life's challenges. Spiritual wellness has the power and capability to make our decisions and choices easier, ground us during periods of a change, and help us in face of adversity. Having a spiritual element in our lives may help us heal when suffering from a physical or a mental condition. Taking care of yourself is vital to have a good emotional health. Take care of your body by having a regular routine of eating healthy meals, getting enough sleep, and exercising. Avoid abuse of drugs or alcohol, as it can only cause more issues to you. In general, focus on the things in your life that you are grateful for, and try not to obsess about the problems in your day-to-day life that lead to negative feelings. Try to maintain a journal. It helps to keep track of things that make you happy or peaceful. And it also will help find ways to let go of the things in your life that make you feel stressed and overwhelmed. Remember, Always make time for things that you enjoy and bring peace to your mind. Thank you for watching. Check the description below for links to contents related to this topic. If you like this video, don't forget to give a thumbs up and share with your friends. If you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe to the channel so that you can receive future videos from my channel. Once again, thank you for watching.